Hello world, and welcome to the Coding After Effects ExtendScript series. And in this series, I'm going to talk about ExtendScript for After Effects, of course. And if you follow my channel, you know I go into details about how to write expressions and how to use it. Well, in this series, of course, I'm going to go into detail on how to use ExtendScript. And if you're wondering what's the difference between the two, basically, when you're using expression, you're changing the properties or automating animation from the layer's property. And with expression, you can't really access certain things. So you couldn't access the composition menu. You can't create a new composition, nor can you control things like the timeline or the time indicator or anything beyond that layer property. With ExtendScript, you can just about access anything inside of After Effects and control it and code it in a way that it does what you want it to do. So, in short, if you just want to make some animation and you want to do it in an automatic way, you're better off using expression, unless you're doing something more complicated where it involves creating new layers, or you're creating something beyond that layer property. So to even access ExtendScript, you would go inside of the file menu and you would go into import. No, script down here. I'm crazy. And you would go to open script editor. But for whatever reason, if I try to do it, it give me some problems. So I would have to open it up from a shortcut on my desktop. You might have to do that too, but just know that this might be a common problem. I don't know. So right now we're in ExtendScript Toolkit, which is really hard to say for me for whatever reason. And what we're going to do is we're going to write a simple hello world, something people usually do when they're learning a new language. So if I type in alert, now this might look weird, but I'm pretty sure you've seen alert before, maybe on some type of annoying website where you go to the site and for whatever reason they use a pop-up box and they don't want you to leave that site. We're going to use that same type of code or function in here by writing alert and inside these parentheses in quotes writing hello world. So if I write that and go to this little play button, I get hello world. This is cool, but as you know, this is only working inside of ExtendScript. And what we really want to do, we want this application to talk to After Effects. So in able to do that, we're going to go up to here and we're going to change this into our After Effects version. And right now, even though I got 2018, I'm using 2017 mostly because of some GUI issues. So if I was to go back to this little play button and run the script and I go back to After Effects, I get nothing. That's weird. Now if I click on this run script, I go back to After Effects and I get hello world right here. And there's a few other ways I can talk to After Effects, and as far as text, I could get rid of this and write and push play. And if I go in my Windows and go into info, something should have been written there. Let me push play again and I get hello world. And I pushed it twice and I don't know why it didn't come up the first time, but I got Hello World twice. And if I was to go in here and type in L, capitalize, and for right line, and I push play, and I go back in After Effects, this should have been a new line, but it's not giving me a new line. So let me see if I push play again. There we go. Let me write something else. And it doesn't have to be words or in a string in order for you to actually use it. You can push 5 plus 5 and it should give me 10. Yep, there we go. And one more thing. If I want to get rid of this that's on this information panel or window, I go in here and I type in clear output with a capital O, semicolon, push play again, go back to After Effects, and this is all clear. And that's really the basics of running ExtendScript. And of course, there's more stuff that ExtendScript can do than write Hello World and write it in the information window. And I'll go over that more in the future tutorial, but this is just to get you started so you can kind of understand what's going on. I hope that you enjoyed the video. And if you do, I hope you check out my previous videos. Until the next time, peace out, world.